In this video, we're going to look at the equations that Xfoil uses to calculate the section coefficients and the Reynolds number. We're going to then compare that to the conventional equations to find out what assumption Xfoil is making that can trip us up. This is brought to you by the Science of Flight. Let's get to it. In order to understand the results that Xfoil gives to us, we need to understand one of the assumptions that it makes when calculating the coefficients and Reynolds number. And that's the topic of this video. Starting on the left side of the slide, we have the conventional or traditional equations to calculate the section coefficients and Reynolds number. Now, the reason I emphasize the word section is because we are dealing in two dimensions here. The idea behind this is that we are ignoring any span-wise effects. We're just looking at the two-dimensional cross-section and how our free stream flow flows around this shape. The notation to use to signify that we're looking at section coefficients instead of the normal three-dimensional coefficients is that we use the lowercase l, d, and m for the section coefficients. So if you see a C lowercase l, then you're looking at the section lift coefficient. But if you see a C capital L, you're looking at a three-dimensional lift coefficient. Unfortunately, this isn't always the case, so just be careful and double check. Now, one of the big differences between a section lift coefficient and a normal three-dimensional lift coefficient is what is used to normalize the lift value. In a two-dimensional lift coefficient, the lift produced by the shape is normalized by the chord. In a three-dimensional lift coefficient, the lift produced by the wing is normalized by the planform area. However, if you notice, the section moment coefficient has a c squared term in its denominator. A three-dimensional moment coefficient would replace one of those c's with an s to signify the planform area. So that's how the conventional section coefficients and conventional Reynolds number is calculated. Now, on to the assumption that Xfoil makes. When Xfoil is calculating these section coefficients, it assumes that the chord is equal to 1. So that'll essentially drop C out of all of the equations on the left. Now, I'm not 100% sure I know why it does this. I assume it's because outside of conventional airfoils, the idea of a chord is kind of arbitrary and hard to define for irregular shapes. And this is fine unless you either imported an airfoil that did not have a chord of 1, or you scaled the current airfoil you were working on to a chord length of greater than or less than 1. And on the next slide, we'll go over an example of why assuming the chord is equal to 1 can cause problems when looking at an airfoil that does not have a chord of 1. On the left side of the screen, we have an example where the Naka 4412 airfoil is loaded into Xfoil and normalized with a chord equal to 1. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at a flow of 500,000 Reynolds number at an angle of attack of 3 degrees. And then on the right side of the screen, we're going to do the exact same thing, but instead of a normalized chord of 1, we're going to actually have a chord of 0.5. Now, this could have happened if you left the normalization flag off when you were importing, or maybe you simply scaled the airfoil when you were manipulating the geometry in the GDES menu. If you look at the first example, the section lift coefficient is 0.8, the section drag coefficient is 0.0082. Because the chord was normalized to 1, the inputted Reynolds number and the effective Reynolds number that the airfoil quote-unquote sees is the same. For example 2, though, you'll notice that the section lift coefficient and section drag coefficient are lower than the first example. What clues us into the reason that the numbers are different is the effective Reynolds number that the airfoil is seeing. Since the chord is cut in half and the chord is part of the definition of Reynolds number, even though we specified the flow to be 500,000 Reynolds number, the flow around this smaller airfoil was not what we specified. It is effectively seeing a flow with a Reynolds number that is half of the specified Reynolds number. And this is why the coefficients are not the same. So for the second example, if we were looking to find out what the section lift coefficient was on this NACA 4412 airfoil at 3 degrees angle of attack at a Reynolds number of 500,000, but we used a non-normalized chord that was only 0.5, this section lift coefficient of 0.4 would be incorrect. Now, if I had to give an analogy of what happened on the second example, and I'll admit it's probably a bad analogy, I would use the analogy of a wind tunnel test. If you can imagine, you made the wind tunnel model, put it into the tunnel, and then sat down at the computer to start the tunnel. You then entered in that you wanted it at 3 degrees angle of attack, so the mountain moved the model to 3 degrees angle of attack. Then you started up the flow by saying that you wanted a Reynolds number of 500,000, which in reality you'd probably be specifying the speed of the flow that you needed or whatever current to the motor that you needed to adjust the flow in the tunnel up to what you thought was a 500,000 Reynolds number. And you collected data, and when you pulled the model out of the tunnel, you realized you used the wrong chord length. So what happened was when you sat down at the computer and started up the flow and adjusted the flow to the speed or the motor current that you thought would give you a 500,000 Reynolds number, really you adjusted the flow and it only gave you a Reynolds number of 250,000. And so the numbers that you collected, while correct for the flow that it encountered, is incorrect for the flow that you wanted to investigate on your model. And I think the key takeaway here is that when dealing with airfoils, you want to either normalize them so that the chord is 1, or when specifying the flow conditions, or rather when specifying the Reynolds number, you take into account the fact that the chord is not 1. All right, and with that in mind, we're going to go ahead and end the video here. If you like what you saw and want to see some more, show your support for the channel. And since it's 2018 and you probably hear this 20 times a day, I'm not going to tell you how to. I'll see you in the next video. Psst. Like, comment, subscribe.